Hello everybody, welcome back to my next tutorial on Android framework components. And by the way, this is Dimple here. In today's session, let us see what are the different folders in the Android source code. So the Android source code contains variety of folders. So in today's session, we will understand what is the roles and responsibility of each of the folders. So here is a diagram which shows how the folders looks like, but this diagram is not very clear. Never mind, I'll explain each and every folder in this session. So let's begin. First, we'll see what is ABI. ABI stands for Application Binary Interface. This folder contains a subfolder called CPP, which actually contains many C++ files linked to many places. So ABI contains a folder called CPP, and CPP contains all the C++ files which are required for the operation of Android system. Next, we'll see ART, Android Runtime. So it is the folder that deals with compilation of the latest Android ART runtime. All the compilation of the Android takes place in the ART, and this ART contains the source which does that operation. Next, we'll see what is Bionic. So Bionic is mainly a part of BSD C library to our Linux kernel with the following changes. So Bionic is nothing but a C library which is present in the Android system. So there is no support for locales. There is no support for white characters, that is multi-byte characters. It owns smallish implementation of pthreads based on Linux features. And Bionic supports x86 ARM and ARM Thumb CPU instruction sets and kernel interfaces. So in short to tell, Bionic is nothing but the C library required for Android system. We require many libraries, right? So the source code comprises of the source plus libraries plus all the dependencies, C++ files, native files, everything. So in the similar way, Bionic contains all the C libraries which is required by the Android system. Next, there is another folder called Bootable. Bootable includes all the boot and startup related code, how the Android system should boot, what should happen in the boot, all these things are handled in this bootable folder. And this bootable folder will also include fast boot protocol support, how the fast boot things should happen, all the step-by-step procedure is present in the bootable folder. So let's continue. Our next folder is build. So I have written all these folders, I have named all these folders according to alphabetical order. So our next folder is build. So the main entry point of the build system resides here, env setup.sh. So this env setup.sh, you have to execute this source build slash env setup.sh as the first step. So before you start building the Android source code, the first step that has to be executed is building the environment setup. So what does this env setup will do? So env setup, environment setup shell script will check few things to make sure that all the applications which are needed for a successful build are available in your local machine. And also it will set up the device that can be built, which is extracted from device directory. Let's move on. Next is CTS, compatibility test suites. So what is this compatibility test suites? So this is the test suite that is required to ensure build complies with Android specifications. So whatever you're building, all that will comply with Android specifications. So Google has few specifications. Only if we meet all those, we get a good Android product or Android device. Otherwise, we cannot offer for an Android device. So all those specifications in the build are checked in the CTS folder. So it contains test suite to ensure that the build complies with Android specification. So Dalvik is the folder responsible for the compilation of the Dalvik runtime for the Android devices. Development. So this is the directory which contains applications that are not part of the deployed application in the OS. So development directory will contain apps which are not part of the deployed apps in the OS. And there are some useful applications like widget, builder, etc. Next, let us see the device directory. So device contains the device specific configurations for many devices. Okay, so all the device specific configurations are contained in this directory, and device has four different subdirectories: common, generic, Google, and sample. So what does this common do? So common folder has a script which can extract a binary information from the Android device which is needed for the build process. Generic folder will have device configurations which are very generic, and mostly regarding your Android emulator, all those source code will be present in this generic folder. And Google folder will have Android kit, and sample will have an Android sample example from which where you can develop your other applications. Google folder will have Android accessories kit. So these are the four different subfolders under the device folder. Next, let us see external directory. This directory contains source code for all external open source projects such as SQLite, FreeType, WebKit, and WebView. So there are external open source projects which are not part of Android open source. They are some of the examples are WebView, WebKit, SQLite. All these will be part of the external directory. Next comes the framework directory, which is one of the very, very important directory. So most of the source code regarding your Android framework will be part of this framework directory. So it contains the source code for all the framework. And it acts as a bridge between the application level APIs and your native source code. And also, I have told that system server will be the first process to be started. Once system server is started, all other process will be initiated, all other managers. For example, system server will be started first, and later on, it will start one by one. Activity manager, package manager, battery manager, window manager, and so on. So the system server source code is also present in this framework directory. So framework is one of the very, very, very important directory in your build source. Next comes the hardware directory. Hardware related source code regarding all the hardware abstraction layer, and also information regarding modem side, which is radio interface layer. All such things are included in the hardware directory. So all the hardware related information is present in this particular directory. Our next folder is kernel folder, one of the very, very important folder, as important as the framework. So this folder is not a default folder in the source code, but it's a part of device configuration setup. It contains the kernel source of your device. All the kernel source of your device contains in this source code or this folder. Next, we'll see libcore. So libcore directory or folder have many other different subfolders. We will see one by one. First one is Dalvik. So libcore library core, it contains Dalvik virtual machine runtime for Android, expectation. So it has a subfolder called expectations, which contains information about the test cases, how the test case should execute. All those information are present in the expectation folder, which is a subfolder of libcore. Then there is an include folder, which contains C or C++ files used for array and string handling. Okay, then there is a JSON folder. JSON based Java implementation information is provided in that folder. Very important folder called Luni. It contains test source code for loading .jar and .dex files. Okay, .jar and .dex files, all these for all these things Luni is present. Then there is another folder called support, which contains support files for testing Dalvik, all the test cases it will contain. Next we have XML file, which contains XML pull and push implementation. I'll provide another information here. Through ADB, Android Debug Bridge, we can pull an XML file from an Android device, or we can push an XML file to an Android device. We can pull from a particular location, or we can push to a specified location. So all that implementation is present in the XML folder, which is coming under libcore. So libcore has Dalvik, expectations, include, JSON, Luni, support, and XML. Next, we'll see NDK. NDK stands for Native Development Kit. So it contains build scripts and helper files for building the NDK. All the native apps, how they have to behave, all that is coming under NDK folder. So let's see our next folder, out folder. Again, this is a very, very important folder in the build source code. So as I already previously told, in order to start the build, we have to first make the environment setup to check if all the applications are supported for the build process. So we'll give source build slash env setup dot sh. After that, we execute the make command. So after make command, if the build is completed successfully, then all the output will be present in this out directory. All your binaries, the system image, boot image, user image, recovery image, cache image, or all the APKs or the jar files, all the outputs of the build are present in this particular out directory, and it is in out target and product directory. So output regarding your emulator are present in out target product generic directory. So again, this is the one of the main file which we look for after the build is completed successfully. Let's move to our next folder, packages. So all the system applications which are installed on your device, all of them will be part of this packages. For example, your calculator, calendar, Chrome, phone, dialer, launcher, SMS messenger, all of these which are system apps will be listed under packages. So in packages, there will be folders to contain the source of the application and contain the resource files for that application. So each of these application will have an MK file, and that will be executed when you give build. Okay, so everything will be so this packages will have subfolders like source, resource, all of such things for each application. Next, we'll see pre-built. So pre-built directory or folder contains files that are distributed in binary form for convenience. So for convenience, few files will be distributed in binary forms. All such files are present under pre-built directory. Examples include the cross-compilation toolchains for different development machines. SDK, again, SDK stands for Software Development Kit, which is again very, very important folder. Without an SDK, we cannot compile an Android application. So this directory contains lot of Android apps that are not part of the operating system. There are quite useful apps that developers can leverage and can be enhanced further as part of the operating system. So SDK folder contain apps which are not part of the operating system, but developers can enhance these and make them the system application. So once they are made system applications, they become part of the OS, operating system. So again, SDK is very, very important for compiling any Android apps. Next, we'll see system. So system is again a very important folder. Source code files for all the core Android system. So all the core Android system source code files are present in the system folder. So this includes source code for init process and the default init.rc script that provide the dynamic configuration of the platform. So in my previous session, when I was explaining the Android boot process, I have told you all that init.rc file will be loaded by the kernel. So once init.rc will be executed, then zygote process will be created. So all the core parts are present in this system folder or subdirectory. Folder or directory. Next, we'll see tools. Tools contain some external important tools that help in compiling. Some of the external tools which help in the process of compilation are present in this tools folder. Next, let us see the vendor partition or the vendor directory, what it includes. So vendor is the directory which contains vendor specific libraries. So all the third party vendor specific libraries will be provided in this vendor folder. So most of the proprietary binary libraries from non open source projects are stored here when building AOSP. So vendor, in simple lines to tell, they contain third party source codes in this partition. Next, there is dot repo folder. So apart from the above mentioned folders, whichever I told till now, there is a hidden dot repo directory that contains the source code for the repo utility. Okay, so repo utility we make use when we are preparing for the build. That means first we have to repo sync our code. Only after repo sync is successful, we can use build. It also contains a manifest specifying what Git repositories you want to track for this Android source project. So each of the folder which I explained one by one here plays a prominent role in the Android source code. So each of them have their own specific functionalities and have their own specific responsibilities. Only when all of these are combined together and when all of these work flawlessly, a successful build will be available. So once a successful build is available, we can flash those images on our Android system. So this was it for today about the different folders in the Android source code. I hope this information was helpful and I hope this tutorial was useful for y'all. Thanks everyone for your time and stay tuned with my upcoming videos to get more information on Android framework components. Thank you all. Take care. Bye. See you soon in my next tutorial.